Okay guys, so I just wanted to touch over a few points of how to solder and how to and what I was doing with that DNA 60 chip, that you guys can do it yourself. And I have some major points that you guys need to keep in mind when you purchase one of these guys, one of these soldering irons from Amazon or from anywhere else. There's a certain heat that they can produce, and you want to keep it as low as possible, especially when assembling a chip that has SMD components and it has very small parts to it, because those parts are very delicate, even though they have like a certain heat index. Index is definitely not a word. They have a certain heat that they can withstand. That heat is usually over-marketed. Like, they say that they can be a certain type of temperature and still be able to function. That is not true. Trust me, no matter what they say. If you go ahead and stick this guy on here onto one of your small little tiny miniature 2mm by 2mm wide SMD component parts, that's a lot of heat for that small, for that tiny little chip. That's a lot of heat for that tiny little chip, man. That is. This thing, it says, basically, it goes up to, goes from 200, and it's in fucking Celsius, because it's from China, because I don't know what temperature they have over there, but. Goes from 200 degrees Celsius. To 400 degrees Celsius, and that's pretty high. 400 degrees Celsius is like 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit or something like that. It's something ridiculous. Anyway, you want to be careful. You want to turn it on the lowest heat possible, which I have it like halfway, a little bit more, which I should turn it down. I don't know how I got up that high. I might not be a professional, but I know what I'm talking about. Anyway, if you go on Google.com, use the search bar, you can type in, that sounded really sarcastic and like really bitter. I don't know why I felt like it's emphasizing my words that way, but it happened. We'll see. Anyway, yeah, just go on Google and type in the maximum temperature or what temperature you should be setting your soldering iron at. And I'm gonna do that right now because I seem like an idiot if I don't have the actual solution to you guys. So let me go ahead and pause this. Okay, so you can clearly see that 400 degrees Celsius is way, well, not way over the maximum temperature, but it can fry your SMD components, because I looked that shit up on Google. And I trust Google. I trust Google. I don't know what everybody else has to say about Google, but they have a very potent record of every single thing that we've ever seen that makes us who we are. So they're like Jesus. I don't know what to fucking call Google. Do you? Google is like the best teacher that has ever been invented, which is basically like saying human teachers are not as good as robot teachers, and I have to disagree with that because my mother is a teacher and I support her, and she does a much better job than all these computer shenanigans. Oh, it's just so sickening. Welcome to the fucking future. Future. Just kidding. I do agree with what I just said, but I also disagree strongly. A lot more strongly than I agree with it. I would say that the future was run by robots. Then you know how you have Twitter and Facebook and Instagram, and you got some followers and you got some other people out there. Well, guess what? If there's less human population and there's more robots than humans, then guess what? Your Instagram followers are like, because there's going to be like one creepy guy jacking off in the fucking corner. If you have a career in YouTube, or you have a career in anything entertainment wise, if robots take over the world, then you're fucked. Seriously. So all the entertainers, maybe that's why robots were created, because jealous people that aren't famous have an opportunity to take over the world and kill every single famous person. That does not satisfy our movement of lack of entertainment and hard work. Specifically, okay, so I was extremely upset because I started doing like a 10-minute outro to this thing. I looked at my camera and it says it stopped recording. Oh no, it didn't say it stopped recording. It said you never started recording to begin with. That means I forgot to hit a button, or I thought I did, and my fingerprint was a little bit fucked up because my hands are a little bit fucked up, so it probably didn't recognize my fingerprint as an actual finger touching the screen. Probably recognized it as like a piece of wood being hit on the button. Anyway, let's redo this again. This is not me bragging by any way. By me saying this is not me bragging made it sound like I'm bragging. So cut that shit out, man. Cut it out, please. This is one of the DNA75C chips that I'm gonna be putting into a box mod, custom box mod, making myself. It's gonna be very spectacular, very innovative, very different, especially since it's a 75C, which means I can do so many things with this guy. So many things. You could do a dual parallel configuration, or you can do a single, or you can do a triple parallel. You can do as many parallels as you want, because when you put it into parallel and you wire it into parallel, we'll get into it later. Anyway, one DNA75C that I'm going to be putting into my own box mod that I make out of either like a hybrid stabilized wood with acrylic, or not acrylic, but like epoxy, or like a resin wood, you know, hybrid, all that stuff. That stuff. And all of this is authentic, you can clearly see. DNA75C. And, so that's one. There's no jump cuts in this. That's one DNA75C. Let me show you the other one. This is another DNA75C. Let me open the package. Anyway, let me just hold them all up. So this is what, this is, because I could jump cut all of this and fool all you guys. No matter what I say, it's not going to convince anybody at the end of the day. Anyway, all three of these. I'm moving it around. I'm talking at the same time. There's no way that I'm fucking jump cutting any of this shit. Fuck. Okay, so you can see two DNA75Cs that are over here that are clearly a little bit tinier than this guy over here, which is a DNA250C right here. God damn it! I swear to God, if I make this defective by dropping this on my carpet, I'm gonna have some shit to say to Evolve DNA. It's gonna happen because I modded so many, not so many. I've wired like three of their chips and no issues except for the fact that I had too much heat applied to the components, or not the components, the soldering points right here. I had too much heat applied to those, so that fried out some other components, and also I was being a dumbass and rushing it. Don't do that, guys. Don't apply too much heat. Maximum is like 315 degrees Celsius, which is something degrees Fahrenheit. I don't know. I don't feel like looking it up. Anyway, you guys can look it up. 315 degrees Fahrenheit. 315 degrees Celsius. I usually do, let's see, like 250. 200 to 250 degrees Celsius on this guy. That is like the perfect temperature. Ever since I started doing that, I stopped having chips that started to fail on me either instantly or after a week of use. Guys, please keep that in mind. If your soldering iron is in Fahrenheit, please do the calculations to figure out that it is lower or the same as 315 degrees Celsius. If not, you need to lower your heat, or else you're gonna have a lot of bad experiences like I did, and it was very frustrating, and it cost me a lot of money, dude. A lot of fucking money. This is like the biggest fucking switch that you'll ever fucking see. And I'm gonna be putting this into a box mod because it has like the ability to handle at least like 30 amps. So you can basically do a parallel /series box mod, all you have to do is flip a switch to flip it from parallel to series, and it's gonna be like a MOSFET, because there has to be like a MOSFET inside of this guy, this giant fucking switch, to make it be able to handle 30 amps and these giant contacts. Like, look at this shit. So that's gonna be a lot of fun, guys. Anyway, yeah, all three of these guys, big brother is in the middle. That's the DNA250C. The one on the left and the one on the right are DNA75Cs. So yeah, these guys are gonna be a lot of fun. I love DNA mods. I love the DNA chip. I love how you can customize your little screen and everything with all the colors and shit. And it's so fucking accurate, dude. And that not bypass mode, but that temperature sensing mode. What the fuck is it called? Anyway, all that shit's coming up. It's gonna be a lot of fun. Thanks for listening, guys. Custom Mod signing out. Keep on vaping. I'll see you guys next time.